Greetings, everyone. My name is Connor Lenz, and I work with the committee that coordinates this event for the court each year, and I would like to welcome all of you to the 19th Annual National Adoption Day celebration. This is part of a nationwide celebration of adoptions that occurs the third Thursday of each November. I know that I speak for each of the folks here at the court that have a hand in this event when I say that this is our favorite day of the year. It never feels like work when we get to celebrate you, the forever families that we honor here today. We so appreciate you being with us for this virtual event. And to start things off, I'm going to turn it over to our Masters of Ceremonies, the Honorable Judge Dean Lum.
Thank you so very much, Connor. And welcome to our families, our friends, our judicial officers, attorneys, well-wishers, and people who have gathered here to celebrate this incredible, wonderful occasion. This is the 19th annual King County Superior Court National Adoption Celebration. And of course, we're under really extraordinary times. But as a testament to the resiliency of everyone involved in adoption, we found a way to celebrate this special day. Our court hearings have all gone virtual, and I've been told that we performed well over 14 adoptions this morning and went off without a hitch. Our families and friends were able to gather together to finalize those adoptions, and virtually all of those families are gathered here today with us to have this this public celebration. In addition, families from who have finalized their adoptions this past year have also gathered with us. We're here to tell you that there are many children who are available for adoption, many of whom are in the foster care system, and that people can step forward and allow these kids to have a forever family. Now, of course, adoption isn't for everyone, but everyone can support somebody who wishes to go through adoption and finalize adoptions. This is a wonderful, wonderful occasion, and it's particularly wonderful for me. Those of you who know that 62 years ago, I was an orphan in Hong Kong and brought to this great country by some tremendous Chinese-American parents, Abe and Helen. I came to the United States, came to Seattle, grew up on Beacon Hill, went to school in the Rainier Valley, went to law school at the University of Washington. But I got my start here in this great country because people, like many of you, were willing to extend yourselves and offer for a home to someone in need. You're just getting this journey. So thank you very much for what you've done. It's a tremendous accomplishment. I think also we need this moment in time. We have so many challenges. We're in the middle of an incredible pandemic. We have economic dislocation, and many people are hurting. People are looking for news. We know that there are vaccines and other treatments available coming down the pike. But I think these days we're looking for at least a little bit of sunshine, a little bit of news, a little bit of indication that better times are ahead. So from the families that I've talked to this morning, and I know the attorneys as well, so workers, they need this as a reaffirmation that indeed there's still love out there. And the way we're going to get through this is through intelligence, compassion, and a sense of community. So thank you again to everyone. While we're on thank yous, I want to thank our judicial officers who are present, who perform ceremonies and who are also gathered with us today. I want to thank Judge Bender, Judge Ferguson, Judge Oishi, Judge Bijian, Judge Ryan, Judge Becker, and Judge Young, and several others who will be joining us on Zoom call in a few minutes. We also have our adoption attorneys, Albert Lierhuis, Jana Enst, A-N-N-E-S-T, Enst, Div Anderson, Andrew Schneider, Ryan Cross, Erica Varenz, and Fern Herbert. I want to thank our sports teams, the Seattle Seahawks and the Seattle Mariners, Warm 106.9, the Seattle Aquarium, the Family Fun Center, Wendy Wonderful Kids and Children's Home Society of Washington. Our National Adoption Day Committee has worked hard to put this celebration together, so thank you, Connor Lenz, Courtney Angeles, Regina Chin, Suzanne Large, Bushang Vong, Heather Kazmir, Kendra Brown, Taryn McCormick, Gina Reyes, and Tracy White. Special shout out again, repeat, to Jen Reyes. So thank you, friends and family, for gathering here today to celebrate adoptions of all kinds. Thank you. Now this time, I'm going to turn the floor over to some very special guests. We have King County Council members, Kathy Lambert and Claudia Balducci, who have been staunch advocates for children and family for years and have always been incredible supporters of National Adoption Day. So I believe the con will be able to promote them to the panelists at this time. So I'll give you Kathy Lambert and Claudia Balducci.
Hello.
Thank you. Claudia, do you want to start?
Sure, yeah, thank you, Kathy. Hi, my name is Claudia Balducci. I'm the chair of the county council. And also, and probably more importantly for today's purposes, I am an adoptive mom. And I just, I love this day for many reasons, but also because it just personally reminds me of the joy and promise and hope and terror that I felt with my husband and my family as we were embarking on our own journey to become a forever family with our son who we adopted now 13 years ago. Yes, he's an adorable little kid. Here's a picture of when we first met him. That was the very first time we laid eyes on Victor, and now he is a teenager doing middle school upstairs. But I want to just welcome the families, the children and the adults and the extended families into this incredible adventure. You will make each other's lives different, better, more challenging, more successful, more rich than you can really probably even imagine at this point. And I'm so excited and happy for everyone who's participating. I'm so excited and happy for your futures together. And it brings out just a happy sort of feeling to think about all the families that are finalizing today and that are becoming forever families, as I said. I want to thank the courts who make this happen and all the folks that Judge Lum spoke to, because it takes a village to help make families this way. We certainly experienced that ourselves. So many people helped us to become a family, and we've never been the same. And it's been just a wonderful, life-changing experience for everyone involved. So congratulations to everyone. Happy Adoption Day to you all. Thank you for inviting us to say a few words. And I just can't wait to enjoy this celebration with you. Thank you. And now Councilmember Lambert will say a few words.
Thank you very much. Well, I too want to say welcome to all of you. And as Judge Lum said, that this is one of my favorite days too. And I know that I've gotten over the 19 years to look at Judge Lum's parents and their smile. And it isn't quite ear to ear, but it is almost ear to ear, thinking about the child that they started as a little person, and now that he is a judge in our county and doing such a great job. So when we got on, the music that was playing is my theme song, and so I thought that was funny. And so I want to tell you that that song, Celebration, is a really important song to me. And the reason is because it helps me to remember that every day we need to celebrate. And as Claudia said, some days of raising a child will be frustrating. But when you wait long enough to look back on even those frustrations, there will be joys in it. Because I always say that the things that I want to pull out my hair some days that my kids or my grandkids do will be the stories I will tell their children and their children's children and make them all laugh. That yes, in fact, grandma did have to go through that. And they are stories that become the family lore. So while you're going through things in life, if you can think about that in a year, in 2 years, in 10 years, however long, that this will be a funny story to tell. And so let me put the humor in it while I'm going through it, which makes it much easier to go through. A few minutes ago, I tried to type adopted into the computer and it came out adored. And I also had to laugh that spell check knew that that was the right word, adored. So I think it's really important. And earlier this week, the council proclaimed today a National Adoption Day in our county. And as a grandma, I have 18 grandchildren, and I too have raised stepchildren and foster children. And each of them is a blessing. And when I look at my grandchildren, I'm remembered every day how important having your family is. And now during COVID, when you can't go out and be beyond too many other people, I feel so sorry for the people who don't have, in my case, 18 people that I can call and bug and say, grandma wants to hear your story for the day. And so it's really important to have so many loved ones in our lives. So we had 30 local children adopted. And so all the parents who made this powerful decision, we want to say thank you. Thank you not only for what you've done for the children in your new care, but also for their children and their children's children, because it will make a difference for generations. So I would like to tell you a little bit about the Superior Court and the wonderful judges that have made these families forever possible. That there are 7,554 children in the Washington foster system, with more than 100,000 children in the foster care system in the country. And so there's a need to find families who are willing to adopt. And so for the children who are listening, you are very blessed. You have people who will love you always, and that is so important. Recognizing the importance of adoption and what that means to our families and to our community and to our world is what Adoption Day is all about. So thank you for inviting me to this very special event each year, and despite the fact it's a Zoom event, it's full of love. And so thank you for bringing this love to our county and to your new families. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilmember Lambert, and thank you, Councilmember Balducci. We understand that the County Council has also passed a resolution as well. And so I'll hold that for everyone if they wish to come see it. And but we'll publish that on our webpage and also publish that on our social media. But so appreciate everything you've done in the past and present and future. So thank you so very much for being staunch advocates for families and kids. Really appreciate it. Thank you so much. So at this time, I'm going to go to introduce our feature family, and really more for not really a lengthy introduction, because I think they can probably better introduce themselves. But we have at this time our feature family, the Crispin family. And so the Crispin family, can we go ahead and promote them to our panelists then? Okay. And there they are. Okay. All right. That is a tremendous family. They are have smiles all around. Look at that. Shall we go ahead and let's go ahead and have the Crispin family introduce themselves. Take it away.
Let me see. Can you hear us?
Is that us?
Is that us? Can you hear us now? Yes. Okay, perfect. Yeah. I didn't know if the computer would pick it up. Anyway, hi. Yes, we're the Crispins, minus one. We have, we gave each of our kids the opportunity to participate today and the opportunity to say no if they didn't feel comfortable. And one of our kids said he was fine with us talking about his story, but he didn't want to be on the call. So we are actually a family of seven. My husband, Carl, is at the end. My eldest daughter, Anna. This is Mina. This is Nicholas. Eli, and I'm Christy, and our son Isaiah is 12, and he is the one who's not with us today. And we're delighted to be with you all. We're big fans of adoption. It's how our family was formed. We also recognize that adoption is always a bittersweet thing. It's never 100% happy because it is, you know, it is rooted in some sense of loss. And so we always want to go into it recognizing that adoption is both something that is always something that we're grateful for and something we recognize also carries its own unique type of grief. So, but we're thrilled to be with you. And I don't know if you just want me to share or if you want to ask questions, just to share.
Oh. I think you should share.
Okay, perfect. Well, our cat just joined us, so she's quite loud. I trapped the dog downstairs, but I didn't think about the cat, so we might have to, we might have to put her, yeah, there she is. Maybe put her in the bedroom, yeah, because she's going to meow a lot. Well, you know, before I say anything, when we were getting ready to come on the call today, I asked the kids if they, or earlier today, what they like about being adopted and what they don't like about being adopted. So I thought it would be nice to give them a chance to share their own responses to that question if they want to. So, Mina, do you want to answer that question first?
Nick can go first.
Yeah, Eli can go first.
Yeah. Do you guys want me to go first?
Christiana can go first.
Okay. Yeah.
Nice.
Okay.
Well, what I really like about being adopted, in my case, I mean, I kind of feel bad for everybody else because, you know, they didn't get to land right here with all of us.
Thank you.
You know, I kind of lucked out that. But anyway. I like adoption because, you know, it's cool to, like, find permanency. You know, like, a lot of other things fall into place after that.
Okay. Oh, girl. She said she doesn't have anything she doesn't like. I don't want to cut you off, but I'm going to. Okay. we adopted Anna in April of this year. So she was 17 when we adopted her, and she made our family. It's kind of hard to imagine what our family was like before she joined it. So our story is that we became foster parents 7 years ago next month. And 2 weeks after we were licensed, we got our first two children, Isaiah and Mina. Isaiah was 5 years old and Mina was 5 months old when we first got them. And for the first year or so, they were still on a reunification track. And we knew, and everybody who's listening to this who has adopted through foster care knows exactly what that feels like. We were holding loosely to the fact that we completely fell in love with these children the moment they landed in our home. And we knew that our story was not determined yet. It was very much an unknown as we continued to love them and provide everything that we could for them while knowing that we didn't know how long they'd be with us. Well, about a year and a half after they came to us, we finalized the adoption of Isaiah and Mina. And in the meantime, another child joined their biological family and he came home with us from the hospital, and that's Eli. So our family, our first three children were Isaiah, Mina, and Eli, biological siblings, and we adopted the three of them. And after those adoptions were finalized, we thought, you know what? Our family, we kind of have this family now, but we want to stay involved in foster care because we knew that there was a huge need and we just wanted to stay involved. So we continued by being a respite family. And about every quarter or so, we would provide respite care for another foster family. And that's how we got to know Nicholas, because Nicholas, shortly after he came into foster care when he was three, he came to our home the weekend that he turned four. We had him for his fourth birthday weekend, and it was just a respite weekend, and we had no idea that weekend that a few years later we would end up adopting Nicholas as well. He was with us on and off for about a year as we provided respite for his other foster family. And then through circumstances that just kind of happen sometimes in foster care, he needed to move. And that's when they asked if he could move in with us. And his story goes on and on, but the ultimate one is that we finalized his adoption in March. March of this year. But in the midst of that, as sometimes happens in foster care, it is a bit of a roller coaster, you might know. Nick ended up going to another home with some relatives of his who have become dear friends of ours, and we just love them. So he was gone for about 9 months with them. And that's when we got a phone call from a case manager who's probably listening right now. And she said, I know you're taking a break from foster care for a bit, but I have this amazing teenager. And she asked if we would consider doing kind of a short-term thing. Well, it didn't take even 24 hours before we knew that this was meant to be as well. The day that Anna showed up at our door, she and I were dressed alike. It was kind of funny. We were both wearing black hoodies and cargo pants. And she gets out of the car and she's holding a guitar and we're both dressed alike. And I also play guitar. And I looked at her and I was like, well, I think this is kind of meant to be.
I actually play the piano.
Yeah, I play the piano too. And so does
she plays the piano. And
so that's how our family came together. And, you know, I think when people ask me about foster care, what I always say is you just have to keep your heart open. You just have to keep your mind and your heart open. You can't write the story before you get involved, because the story kind of writes itself, and we're just along for the ride. And I think one of the questions that Gina asked me ahead of time was, what have you learned from the experience of opening your home to a child for adoption? And I learned a lot. I don't really know how long I'm supposed to talk right now, but I have a lot to say. One of the things that I have learned is that every child has an incredible opportunity and potential to thrive once they get solid, once their world stops feeling like total chaos and unknowns at every hat. I mean, if you think about what happens when a kid has to move or when a kid has to get adjusted to a new family. And for a lot of our kids, they had to move a few times before they landed in their forever family. And I think just recognizing that that we can't underestimate the importance and power of offering someone a solid place to land. And so that's what's happening today. And I'm really excited for the kids who are getting adopted and the families who are adopting them, because your world is about to get, I think, you know, the unknowns, especially of foster care, they're so emotional and they're so hard sometimes. And it's like when adoption happens, it's not like all of the challenges or, you know, problems even necessarily go away immediately, but you can really start to plan for the future, because one of the big unknowns, which is how long will we be together as a family, isn't there anymore. And that's a huge thing. It's huge for the kids and for the parents. So I really, I love that a lot of you are getting solid today. And I think also I've learned that trauma affects every child, no matter how old they were when they were adopted, and that it's part of their story forever, and no matter how much healing they get, and they do, and I mean, healing does come, but there's always this part that will continue to carry that part, and that's why I describe adoption as a combination of gratitude and grief, because we just have to let our kids know that it's okay to feel that way. And if I had one bit of advice to give to adoptive families, it would be let your kids talk about their story, let them ask their questions, let them talk about the family they came from, and support their need to know as much as they can about who they are before they came to you and who they are now that they're with you. I don't know if that's my cue to wrap up that you just came on.
Thank you so very much. And we so appreciate your sharing with us today. This is a wonderful occasion. So thank you, thank you, thank you for extending yourselves and being willing to share. So with that, we're going to move to our next phase of our program. We have at least one or two special guests, but let's go to our very special guest who is going to tune in by video. I think everyone who has kids of a certain age absolutely knows who he is. He's a Seattle treasure. So without further ado, I'm going to have go ahead and cue our video guest. Okay.
Adoption is the most incredible thing in the world. Hi, everybody. I'm Casper Baby Pants. I just wanted to chime in and say congratulations to all the families that are adopting today. It's such a beautiful thing, and I'm so happy for you all. I'm so excited for your adventure together. I hear there's 276 finalized adoptions today, which is fantastic, because there's thousands and thousands of kids who need a home. And this event is so important because it's really a way to like encourage enthusiasm for adoption. I love that about it. It's the only time judges and families celebrate like this in a courtroom. I mean, it's pretty good it's the only time, because it'd be kind of crazy if everybody was celebrating in courtrooms all the time. So you guys are pretty special. That's the bottom line, which is why I wrote this song. Adoption, it's the most incredible thing in the world. It's a short song, but it's great. I'll play it one more time. Adoption, it's the most incredible thing in the world. All right, guys, have a great day and a great adventure together. And I'm very proud of all of you for sharing your love on such a beautiful day. Take care. Bye-bye.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. E.B. Pants. We're going to move to our next phase of our program. We have a judicial officer who, has been habitually late, a judge who's been habitually late, but this year, he's on time. But he's been having some trouble, I think, manipulating the keyboard. And for some reason, I don't know why he's having that much trouble manipulating the keyboard. Maybe he's thinking about pause or something like that, but... So I think he's going to communicate by, signage? Is that how we're going to, maybe you're a wink. No, I guess you can't wink your eyes or anything like that. But, somehow our special guest is going to communicate. And so, ladies and gentlemen, the Mariners is here in the house, the virtual house, to help celebrate National Adoption Day. And he's really been with us for years and years and years, and I think we're looking down his mouth right now, but he's told me he's so happy to be here with us today. So what we're going to do now is move to the next phase. Just to give you specific first, what we had was 25 children were adopted, had their adoptions finalized this morning, as well as 18 children have previously had their adoptions finalized earlier this year and who are participating with their families here today. So what we're going to do is we're going to call the judicial officers, the judges who finalized those adoptions. We're going to promote them onto the screen as well as the families. And I'd like you to go ahead and, this is the time selfies and, for that kind of thing. But what we're also going to try to do is capture capture a video and then take stills off of the video that we can share them with you. Sometimes the video quality is a little bit better that way. And then we're going to call our families forward and so promote you on the screen. And then afterwards, I hope you'll stay around, because what I'd like to do is have a large gallery view and take a photo if you're one, kind of take a group photo of the gallery. I think one of the things we'd like to do is just visually tell people how many people were here today. And I can see how many people, it's incredible. Well over 100 attendees. But I want to just show people visually what we're celebrating here today. So I'd like to go ahead and start. And we'd like to promote Judge Johanna Bender, who's finalized several adoptions this spring. And I'd like to promote to the screen Chris Lee Alexander, and also Stephen and Karen Parents. So Chris Lee Alexander and Stephen and Karen.
Your Honor, I believe the Stroke family is also them together.
Mariners moves.
So congratulations. Thank you so very much. And so fantastic. That is the Stroop family. Fantastic. This is the Matthew and Louise Stroop and Mark and Ashley Stroop, our parents. Congratulations, folks.
Thank you.
Judge Lum, just to let you know, this is the Doe and the Stroop family together.
Oh, okay.
Because
all
they
right.
adopted kiddos who are also siblings of each other. So those two families have formed a really special bond with each other and have kind of all become family to each other.
Fantastic.
Woo! Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Judge Bender. Okay, so our next family and our next judge is Judge Marsh Ferguson. And Judge Ferguson, our first family with Judge Ferguson, Zachary Peter Clark, child, and parents are Timothy Michaels and Dustin Clark. Zachary Peter Clark is a child, and as well as Timothy Michaels and Dustin Clark. Okay, there's Judge Ferguson.
Say hi.
All right.
Say hi.
Okay.
Say hi.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, our next family with Judge Ferguson is Jonna Renee Montgomery, Tayson Michael Montgomery, Malika James Montgomery, Isabella May Rose Montgomery. Parents are Scott Montgomery and Sarah Wendler. Oh, there's the Montgomery family. There they are. Okay, there's a bunch of big smiles. So Mr. Moose, the smiles there.
Hello.
Hi.
My foot.
Thank you. Thank you. And Judge Ferguson, I believe next your last case this morning was Memphis Mercury. I'm afraid I'm going to mispronounce this as Smenk, S-M-E-E-N-K. And parents are Brent and Emily Smenk. So go ahead and promote them to the screen now.
Is Smink family on? I could not find you guys. Can you raise your hand if you are on the call?
Okay. Looks like maybe not right now. So Judge Ferguson, thank you so very much for participating in National Adoption Day again this year. Our next family is Gabriel Alexander Kreman. James and Megan Kreman are the parents, and I believe I finalized this option this morning. So the Kreman family, are there, yeah, I know you're there, and go ahead and turn your video on. There they are, okay, oops. Okay, and this is Gabriel. So, and a happy, happy person. Hello. And congratulations, Kreman family. Thanks so very much. Yay. Okay, thank you. We are next. We have Hunter Matthew Schutz, and Jennifer Schutz is our mom. So, Jennifer, are you there? Okay, go ahead and turn on your video. There she is. Okay, there you go.
Hi, Donkey.
Hi, the moose. Hi, Moose.
Hi, Moose. Hi, Moose.
Thank you. All right. I saw a couple tons there. Okay, all right. Okay, there you go. All right, thank you. Thank you very much. And hopefully you'll join us for the group photo in just a few minutes. Let's see. I believe I Judge Parisian finalized adoption. I don't think the family was able to make it this celebration. But I want to acknowledge Hunter Matthew. Destiny Joy Nyland, Jackson John Nyland, and Aurora Grace Nyland. Parents Brandon and Carissa Nyland. So I don't believe the Nyland family is going to make it, but I think a shout out to her. That family and those kids. Shout out to them. Next, we have Judge Ryan. Let's promote Judge Ryan to the screen. And our first case with Ryan is Cody Justice and Lorelei Justice. Parents are Richard and Ashley Justice. So let's go ahead and acknowledge the Justice family. The Justice family there. And Judge Ryan, Judge.
Yes, Judge, this family is on. I don't see Judge Ryan.
Okay, let's go ahead and bring Justice family up. There's the Justice family. Hello, Justice family.
Hello.
Mr. Moose, what do you have to say? Well, I guess you don't have to say, but how about a shout out and a wave? Okay, fantastic. Congratulations to the Justice family. Thank you so very much for participating in National Adoption Day. Hopefully we'll see you in the group photo in just a minute. Thank you. Let's see, we also have, is it Audrina? Sanessa Fulton, Washington. And Anita Murray Jones Washington. Mom is Megan Holt. So Ms. Holt and let's see, the siblings as well. Is Ms. Holt, there we go. I believe, there we are. Congratulations and fantastic. Okay. Thank you so very much. Now let's go ahead and promote Judge Julie Spector. Judge Spector finalized several adoptions this morning. Our first adoption matter with Judge Spector is Jasmine Hope Francis and Sophia Jean Francis. The parents are Joseph and Lori Francis, the Francis family. Let's go ahead and see whether we can promote Judge Spector and the Francis family. Okay, there, I see them popping up. And go ahead and turn on your videos if you have them turned off. Okay, that looks like Francis family there and some serious balloons. There's Judge Spector. That's fantastic and congratulations, Francis family. It's a wonderful occasion. Fantastic. And congratulations from our wayward judicial officer, the Mariner Moose. Thank you, Mrs. Family. Okay, our next family is Joseph Calvin Bruce Trust, Ariana Marie Trust, Jordan Carl Trust, and Zoe Lynn Trust. The parents are Jason and Lindsay Trust. There's the Trust family. And some fish balloon action going on in that family well. All right, okay. Congratulations, Trust Emily. And thank you so much, Judge Spector. You've been doing a National Adoption Day for so long, and thank you so very much. Really appreciate it. So congratulations, Trust Emily. Now I'd like to promote Judge Linda Young to the screen, and Allie Jo Williams. The parents are Amy Williams and Craig Davis. So Allie Jo, are you there? Allie Jo? Allie Jo Williams is the child. We have Amy Williams and Craig Davis, who are the parents. So I see them kind of starting to pop up. If you go ahead and turn on your video. Yes, we can hear you.
It's not working. Hi. The video is not working, but hi. Oh, there we go. Hi.
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 This is the camera's right there. There you go. Say hi.
Congratulations. All right. So again, this is Allie Jo. Is it Allie or Allie Jo?
Allie Jo. Allie Jo.
Okay.
I'm Adele Davis.
Okay.
The one with the long hair is me.
Thank you so very much. We really appreciate it. And hopefully you'll join us on the group photo in just a few minutes. Thank you. So I'd like to go ahead and thank you, Judge Young. Really appreciate it. Just a slight technical glitch, just a moment, and looks like we've joined. So I'd like to, excuse me, call forward a few families who have previously had their adoptions done earlier this year. First is, the child is Oliver Jean Barut Del Fierro. The parents are Vanessa and Renee Brute Del Fierro. It flies back in August of 2020. And like to call the, there we go. And could we have a wave? Let's have a wave from Oliver. Hi, Oliver. How about a wave? All right, this is Oliver. Congratulations, the congratulations. Next, I'd like to call forth Sion Mackay Bjorn. The parents are Devin and Amy Bjorn. Finalized in April 2020. Is it?
They could not make the celebration.
All right. So we'll acknowledge them and thank you. And so we'll move to our next family, which is Araya Cassandra Callier. I believe that's the correct pronunciation, Callier. And Benicia Callier is mom. This adoption is finalized in May of 2020. Okay, and I believe, go ahead and turn on your video. I see the family there is on the, there we go. Hello, hello. I believe this is it Araya? Araya is there. And congratulations on this National Adoption Day. Congratulations. Okay, the next child is Savannah Rose Edwards, and parents are Daniel and Ivana Edwards, finalized March 2020. So the Edwards family, there's the Edwards family. There's Ed's family, and this is Savannah. So hi, Savannah. Congratulations to you. Congratulations to the Edwards family. Oh, hi. Hi. Okay. Fantastic, and congratulations.
Thanks.
Our next children are Caden Connor Elliott and Kelsey Michelle Elliott. The parents are Billy and Michelle. Finalized March 2020. So children are Caden and Kelsey. There they are. There they are. And looks like they have family members there as well. How about a big wave? How about a wave? and family pet as well. And yeah, fantastic. So congratulations so much, and thank you for joining us. You finalized the adoption back in March, but thank you for joining us on National Adoption Day. Congratulations. Next, we have Michael Oliver, Kylie Kellett, and Christopher Ian St. Clair Kellett. Parents are Duncan and Amanda Kellett, and I hope I'm pronouncing the last name correctly. Kellett, K-E-L-L-E-T-T, maybe Kellett.
They could not make it, Your Honor, but they did submit it, and it was in the beginning. We're waiting to get on.
Okay, fantastic. Next, we have Julia Nicole McCollum, Paul McCollum, and Christine Bombaro McCollum are the parents. They finalized this adoption in June of 2020. There they are, Mr. McCollum family. How big wave, and a shout out to them. It's fantastic. Thanks again for joining us. I know that your finalization was in June, but congratulations on this National Adoption Day. Fantastic. Next, we have Hunter Olson and Harley Olson. Parents James and Julie Olson, they finalized their adoption back in September of 2020. So this is the Olson family, and Hunter and Harley are the kids. And I see that I see them being promoted. There they are. There's the Olson family.
Harley.
Harley.
Hi. Harley, look.
There we are.
Hi. We're happy to be adopted because I like to be adopted by my parents. So.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you for joining us today. Okay. Our next family is, our next child is Kalia Solil Reker, or Raker, R-E-K-E-R, and Sarah Raker or Reker, and Aaron Edwards are the parents. They finalized their adoption on August 18, 2020. There they are. Wait, say hi. Hello, hello, hi.
Hello.
Hello, hello. And thank you for joining us. Again, a finalization was back in August 18, 2020. Which is a day that all of us celebrate. We, you know, several birthdays, of course, and this is one of the birthdays. You'll find that out soon. But congratulations. Our next child is Kyler Romig, R-O-M-I-G, and Mary is the mom, finalized on July 24, 2020. So the Romig family.
I could not find them. If you are here, can you please raise your hand?
Okay. Not to you, Mr. Okay. Okay. So while we're trying to find them, we'll go to our next family, which is the child is Andrew Allen Sanchez Westfall, and Maria Villalobos is the mom. Finalization was September 29, 2020. Do we have Andrew on the call with us?
I could not find them either. If you're here, can you please raise your hand?
All right. So meanwhile, we'll go to our next child, which is Marshawn Jacob Serrano. The parents are Jacob and Rebecca Serrano. Looks like the Serrano. There's the Serrano family, on a theme. Look at all those balloons in the back. This is a tremendous celebration. Fantastic, and I really like your balloons back there. Congratulations.
Hi.
Serrano family, thank you so very much for participating again this year. Now, let's go to our next child, which is Ty Weidler Steele. And Holly Steele is mom. So, do we have the Steele family on?
Okay,
not find them. If you're here, can you raise your hand?
Okay, we'll come back to that if they're here. And then we'll move to Elias Alvarez Trujillo. Parents are Juan Alvarez Juarez and Alejandra Trujillo Rincon. Let's see, finalization January 17, 2020. Looks like they're here, and if you turn on your video, and there they are, and let's get a wave. Congratulations. This will be your kind of second birthday or second celebration. And thank you so very much. Again, finalization was back in January 2020, so a while ago, but thanks for participating in National Adoption Day.
Thank you.
Next, we have Jacob Riley Wickler. Parents are Eric and Amanda Wicklin. So the Wicklin family, do we have the Wicklin family with us today?
I could not find them. If you're here, please raise your hand.
Okay. Next, we have Jalen Amajus Wiles, and Christine and Leon Wiles are the parents. Looks like they're here. The Wiles family. There they are.
Hi. Hello.
Hi. And this is Jalen. Is that right? That's Jalen. Hi, Jalen.
Yeah.
Right. Hi.
Hello. Hello.
We just want to say thank you to the courts and everyone that's been able to make this a possibility, and all our friends and family.
Yes, thank you. We really appreciate that. Thank you. So, Gina, do we have any of the other families who earlier, didn't respond yet? I know the Wild family sent us a text, so we were able to get them, and really appreciate that. Gina, do we have any others?
I don't believe so, Your Honor.
All right. So with that, I'm going to ask, what we're going to do is do a group photo, like I mentioned a little bit earlier. And so if you will bear with us just for a few minutes, I'm going to have our staff kind of promote people from the audience, and we can only promote the families and the judges, and won't be able to promote the extended family and friends and that general public and that kind of thing. They'll still remain a webinar format, but if you bear with us, our staff is going to start migrating folks onto the kind of presenter screen, and then we can take a large photo with after we do that. So just bear with us for a few minutes. It's kind of obvious who's on. And again, if you don't want to be on it, you can not turn on your screen, but it'll be, I guess, a selfie opportunity, as well as we're going to try to capture the screenshots as well off of the video feed. And if you don't want to be captured on this in the group photo, you can just not turn on your video. Okay, all right. So I can see. Okay, there are lots of families, lots of judges. It's fantastic.
Next to the man! Woo! Woo! Woo!
Bye, Joseph.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye. Oh, Chris is drinking out of a bottle like
on the group photo.
Did you get it?
Oh, it is.
Okay, so I can do that. The Edwards family, the Craven family, the Schultz family, Councilmember Lambert, the Trujillo family, the Recker family, Judge Spector, Judge Bender, Callier family, let's see, Elliot, yes, absolutely. Justice family, Friends family, that's fantastic. Okay, all right. Okay, I'm going to take my selfie right now. So Gina, could you tell me when you think, let us know when you think we've gotten kind of critical mass, as many people as could be in the photo.
I believe we should have everyone now.
Okay. All right. And are we able to get them on? Okay, so if anybody else wants to be in the photo who actually is a family or judge, could you raise your hand if, you know, on the raise your hand feature, if we've missed you. Obviously, we can't promote general public, we can't promote, you know, extended families and that kind of thing and friends. But if there's anyone else in the, who needs, you know, who should be in this photo, please let us know through the raise your hand feature. All right. Yes, Mr. Moose. We got you. No. Okay. All right. Okay. Yes. Okay, Gina. Let us know when you have.
I think we have everyone.
Okay. So first, I'd like everybody to have a big smile and a big wave. Let's have a big wave for everybody. Let's do an adoption wave. All right. Okay. Like Gina, are there other photos we need?
I have sent a few to Beth, but I think we're doing later.
Okay. All right. So with that, I want to thank everyone so very much again for this wonderful occasion. You're just incredible. Thank you so very much to mom and dads who are willing to extend themselves to these wonderful kids. So next year will be 20 years. And so I look forward to that. But in the meantime, please have a safe and wonderful day. And thank you again so very much for participating in the 19th annual King County Superior Court National Adoption Day Celebration. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day.